It's really hot here.
It's a bit toasty, you know what I mean?
A bit toasty.
Blooming boiling.
I'm trying to sound British.
And I'm trying to sound American. It's roasting here, you know?
Roasting here.
Y'all hear me? It's roasting.
Yeah. What is something that you say British something?
What we call bumpers on a car, you guys call fenders.
Fenders?
We have fender bumpers. Benders, we have smashes.
Smash?
Yeah.
Smashes. Smashes. You My daughter had a smash.
Did she?
Yeah.
It's a bad one.
Bad smash.
Oh, dearie me.
Mm-hmm.
Bad
case
Barney
of butchers.
Bubble. Yeah. We follow routes. You guys follow something else.
Routes?
Yeah.
We have routes. That's very close. Route? A route? Paper route?
No, that's all wrong.
School
all
bus wrong. Route? This is my friend Michael. Michael is from the other side of the world, and when you hear him speak, you'll kind of figure that out, right? He is from Great Britain, United Kingdom.
Yes.
England.
Yes.
Three different things you call it.
Depends. It can be English, British, United Kingdom-ish, European, if you go that way as well.
Yeah.
We're multicultural.
So he's come over here to visit with me in South Mississippi. Why in the world would he want to do that, right?
It's amazing.
We have come up with an idea for a game. What we're going to do is we have found a list of words that are the same meaning, but different words that we use, that we would use here in the United States, and you would use where you live in...
Speaking proper English in England.
Yes, right. Yeah. So he's going to try to teach me how to sound British.
I speak English correctly.
English correctly.
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 Like the Queen.
Like the Queen.
The Queen.
Cockney, mate.
Cockney, mate.
So we're going to work on that, and then I'm going to try to get him to sound like he's from here.
We've had a fun few days, actually, of working out what we're talking about.
Well, we went to the beach. Yesterday.
Yeah.
And you can tell I look a little burnt. And today we went to New Orleans.
New Orleans.
Hung out in New Orleans. It was really good. Had some good food. Yeah.
Po' boy.
Yeah.
Red rice and beans.
He didn't know what red rice and beans.
He's just a po' boy.
Nobody loves me.
No.
I'm just a po' boy from a po' family.
You say this.
Pants.
Yeah, but we say the second one.
Well, say that. What do you say?
Trousers. We don't wear pants what you wear underneath your trousers. If someone takes their pants down, they're naked.
You wear?
Trousers.
Trousers. Trousers?
Trousers.
Trousers.
Nearly.
Yeah?
Trousers.
Trousers.
Trousers. In Cockney, trousers.
Trousers.
You're better at Cockney than Queen's English.
Yeah? Can you say pants?
Pants.
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 Yeah, you're pretty
good. About the seat of my pants.
Hey, good. This is one I had never heard before. The napkins, like we use in a restaurant to wipe our face. Napkin? Yeah. Napkins. Napkin.
Yeah,
you say napkin.
Napkin.
Napkin. Napkin.
Napkin.
Yeah.
Napkin.
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 And little kids go, I want a napkin.
Napkin.
Yeah, napkin.
I want a napkin.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're doing pretty good. But what do you call it?
Serviette.
A serviette. I thought at first he was saying Soviet.
So Serviette Union.
Yeah. Serviette. Like service.
Yeah, so it's one of those words that have crept into the English language. It actually comes from France.
Oh, France.
It's one of those French words.
France.
It's kind of... Sorry
Paul.
To all my French
Paul,
friends.
You tell him. Tell him, Paul.
Right, mate.
Paul. Paul's going to watch this and he's going to laugh. Paul.
Paul's gonna have a butcher's at this and he's gonna have a chocolate.
Geese a butcher's.
Paul's gonna have a butcher's.
Geese a butcher's.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you know the nursery rhyme, you hear about the porridge? Yeah?
Three bears, porridge.
Yeah, porridge.
Yeah.
We have oatmeal.
What is it?
Oatmeal, porridge.
Can't understand you.
Porridge?
Oh, yeah, porridge.
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 That's it, yeah.
Porridge.
Po' boy, porridge.
Okay, and we have oatmeal.
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 Oatmeal. The restroom. You have a restroom. You call it a...
Toilet. Bog. Kazi.
Bog. Toilet.
Depends
toilet.
How posh you are.
Yeah?
We call it the water closet, if you're very posh.
Water closet?
No. Water.
Water or water?
Yeah.
That's another one. Water.
Water.
They drink water?
We drink water.
We drink water.
Water.
Yeah, you did good.
Yeah.
Yeah, you did good. Yeah.
Biscuits.
Yeah?
Which are sweet. They have little chocolate chips in. They can be sweet. You can dip them in tea because we drink tea and even hot tea.
We have cookies and milk. Biscuits and tea?
It's a splendid
thing. Well, here we have sausage biscuits.
That's kind of weird.
Sausage biscuits. Can you say sausage biscuits?
Sausage, sausage biscuits.
You do pretty good, yeah. I'm
getting a hang of this.
Yeah, you're doing good. Mm. And it wouldn't be very good if you dipped a sausage biscuit in tea.
No.
No.
Not by any stretch of the imagination.
And another thing about speaking this kind of English, you have to do this when you talk.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It doesn't matter how much I try to sound British.
British.
I'm not.
What?
I'm not.
What?
No. What?
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 You what?
I'm not. I'm Southern. I'm Southern American, and there's nothing I can do to sound more British.
There's nothing to be wrong with that, brother.
But see, you do good. You're better at it than I am.
I do good, y'all.
There's a lot of people that really try hard to speak Christian, to act Christian, to try to portray that they're a Christian when they're really not. You know, they
Jesus per minute.
Yeah, it's true. And a lot of times, people that go to church may act one way on Sunday and live like the devil the rest of the week. But come that day, boy, they can really put on the part. You know, they put on the mask, they put on the tie or whatever. And what I'm talking about here is not looks. It's not even speech. It's who you are on the inside. It doesn't matter where I live in the world, how long I live there, or what I'm around. I will always be Southern American. I will. Same for you. I mean, you're really good at this. But it always comes through that you are...
Cockney.
British. Be who you really are. And if you are a Christian and Jesus has come inside of you and changed you and your heart is different, then from the inside out, you become a new creation, a new creature. And when that happens, you don't have to act a part anymore. It's part of who you are. I mean, it comes through in your speech. It comes through in the way you react to other people and the way you treat other people. But one of the coolest things about it, and this is evidence of this, is that you can have someone like Michael that's from the other side of the world. He's now my brother. And I say brother, you say...
Buford. Sorry.
Brova.
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 B-U-B-R-U-V-V-A.
Brova.
That's how you say it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Brova.
He's
brother
my brother.
From another mother.
Yeah. Brother from another mother.
That was good.
There you go. So, I mean, we have that common spirit. Mm. We have the same Lord on the inside. So we both have that camaraderie. And we the cool thing about it is that we don't have to pretend. We don't have to act. I can be Scott. He can be Michael. And we can just enjoy living and loving and being what God wants us to be. And the family that he has put around us. It's a good thing. So I appreciate you coming and doing this with me.
Well, I appreciate being
I'm going to keep trying to say these words and sound more British.
Southern hospitality is amazing.
You like it?
Yeah, it's good.
We had a good time.
We've had an amazing time.
Yeah, it's been fun. Yeah. Thank you for joining with me. And we're going to see you soon. Give them heaven.